Cougar foul, number 10, Sydney Freeman, her third, team six.
Seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
The IHSAA Champions Network welcomes you to another continuing coverage of the Boys State Basketball Tournament. We're tonight, this afternoon actually, this morning really, we are at LaPelle High School for the regional round of the Boys State Championship. I'm Jerry Baker. Big Jan Bossier is alongside. A doubleheader for you today, and then coming back tonight at 8 o'clock for the championship game. First up, Wabash Apaches taking on the Frankton Eagles. Big Jan, this is kind of unique. In the tournament, in the sectional, you may play a couple of games, three games perhaps, in a period of 4 or 5 days. But when you get to the regional round of the tournament, where we are right now, for the first time, perhaps all year, you're going to play two games in one day.
Yeah, sometimes they have holiday tournaments that kind of mimic it, and they do that for that reason. But you're right, Big, they get to have their pillow in the sectional when they go home to sleep. They don't bring their pillow. If they do, they don't get to use it very much. But I always reflect when my son played. Most of these kids play AAU, and they play 4 or 5 ball games in a day. Yes, it is a little factor, but only if you let it be.
Well, they're kids, and they don't know that they're supposed to get tired like that.
I remind myself of that.
And by the way, if you're watching this right now and you're within a vicinity where you could drive in and watch the game, my advice, stay home. Because there ain't no place to put you in this gymnasium here, the dog pound at LaPelle High School. It is jammed to the rafters. It has been jammed when I got here an hour plus before the game. They were lined up all the way to the curbs outside the doors trying to get in then.
Yeah, we've been here off and on through the years. Of course, Jimmy Howe, the AD, does an outstanding job. And Frankton, I don't think there's anybody left in Frankton. You see the red. Some of the other colors kind of match up, but I know one thing. It's going to be loud. It's going to be fun. And I think all the games today, Bake, I think are going to be tough, tough ball games to win.
Going to be very competitive. Let's talk first off about the visiting team on the scoreboard, the Wabash Apaches, 21-4 on the year. They're coached by Paul Wright. What is interesting about Wabash, Jan, this team has won now 26 sectionals, but the last time they won one was 1967. So this is a big deal for the fans in Wabash.
Oh, yeah. You know, and their coaches, I'm sure, celebrated greatly in the sectional victory. But every coach's mind knows there's more to be played. And so they want this in the worst way. When you pay your dues as a coach of players and it takes a while to get here, boy, you got to have your best game face on when you play.
They've won three regionals, but the last time they won one was in 1956. They won it in 34, 34, 37, and 56. So this is a big deal for Paul Wright, who's in his sixth year at the school with a record of 62-76. Jan, Frankton comes in with a record of 23-3, coached by Brent Brobston. a 181-92 record. He's been there 11 years now with Frankton High. They've won, this year they won their fourth sectional. They've won two semi-states, but more importantly, a couple of years ago, they won this two-way state championship beating Crawford County 60-32. They want to get back again to Bankers Life.
You know, and I had them earlier in the year, and they beat a really good 4A Southport Ball Club at Southport. So they're very defensive-minded, and I think as this day progresses, defense might be the key word that we use often.
That game you're talking about, they beat Southport in overtime, 49-47. Both these ball clubs, if you look at the statistics, are almost identical. Frankton averages 66.2, Wabash 66.4. Defensively, Wabash gives up 50.2 points a game, Wabash 46.4. What are we looking at?
Well, I think that I'll be surprised if we get in the 60s. I could be wrong. Wabash, if you look at their shots, they shoot a lot of shots. They shoot through the year almost 100 more three-pointers than Frankton does. So they like to get a lot of shots. That being said, Frankton still averages 60, so they do it in different ways. Frankton is more balanced. They'll have two or three players that you'll see shoot. Wabash typically is more of a one-man band, and Trenton Daughtry averaging just under 20. So it'll be interesting how this economy all kind of sorts out when it's all said and done.
And when it gets tournament time, what you've done all year, you like to say we're going to go with what brought us here, but sometimes you just have to adapt to the pressure of the moment.
Yeah, and we've seen that through the years. I mean, both ball clubs will throw wrinkles and try to make you do something you don't want to do.
So we'll be back in just a moment with the starting lineups for this first game of the day. Frankton 23-3, Wabash 21-4. And you're watching the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
The Pacers want you to feel the excitement and be a part of the action. Plan your company, school, or team outing today. As a group, you can play where the pros play. Perform in front of thousands. Pump up the crowd. High five the stars. Bring the noise. Dance your heart out. Take home a part of the game. Great experiences are available for your group. Go to pacers.com/groups.
Never miss a big game by downloading the IHSAA TV app for free on any device. For your iPhone or Apple TV, check the App Store. On your Android or Android TV device, load up the Google Play Store. Have a Roku or Amazon Fire Stick? We have the app for you. Check us out on Facebook Live, Twitter, or YouTube Live by searching for IHSAA TV. Or as always, click to IHSAATV.org for quick and easy access to your favorite IHSAA live and archived events.
You're good at you. You've been you for years. And we're good at your insurance. You're good at laundry basketball. We're good at your insurance. You're good at stopping a gas pump on a double zero. We're good at your insurance. You're good at making funny face sandwiches. And we're good at your insurance. So start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Back at LaPel High School, J.C. Swartling is handling our video. Rick Vanderwallen is producing, directing, and driving the team bus, and he'll be handling all that activity. Brad Silbert will work the sidelines. I'm Jerry Baker. Big Jan Bozier is alongside. And Jan, we're getting set now to meet the starting lineups for these two ball clubs. The Wabash Eagles are the visiting team. On the scoreboard. And here is the starting lineup. What is interesting about this, they only have one player. That is Daughtry, the guard, at 18.4 points, who averages in double figures. So, Jan, they kind of do it by committee. Vogel, 8-1. Gribben, 5-3. Logan Vandervelden, 9-7. And Elijah Vandervelden, 7.5. That starting lineup averages 49 points. They're going to get a lot of points off their bench. And to fill out that 66 that they average.
Yeah, and Daughtry loves to get to the free throw line. He shoots 75% from the free throw line. And the Apaches, both of these ball clubs, and we've already talked about it, but it's going to be the theme as we go forward, is defense. If you get to this honestly, Vic, you get to the regional because you're a solid defensive team.
And you got to go to the boards. What's interesting, Wabash as a team averages 27.2 rebounds a game and 24.3, all but three of those come from the starting lineup. So that's the Wabash starting lineup as they come into this ball game. As I mentioned, 21-4 on the year. So for the Frankton Eagles, here's their starting lineup, and quite the contrast. They have three players in that starting lineup that average double figures. Caden Key, who's their key, at 18 points per game. Hetzel at 10.5, and Dentley at 13.8. Bates averages 5. Kane averages just over 8 points a game. I mentioned they average 66 points a game. 55.5 points come from the starting lineup, and their rebounding total coming into this ball game is 33-3, but they get 20 rebounds out of the starting unit. So when the defense comes in, Jan, they've got some people that could go to the board, but most of their scoring will come from that starting five.
Yeah, it really does. And they love to get half court and get you in the paint. Franken's very good about get you in the paint. And so look for, I know they both score about the same, but as I looked at these ball club and I've seen Franken live, they have no problem going half court. Their comfort zone, but they'll take transition if it's there. Wabash, they love to get a lot of shots in. Look for them to push it maybe a little bit if they can.
Wabash last year was 12-11. Look at the improvement they made to 21-4. They lost to Oak Hill 70-59 in the opening game of last year's sectional. Other side of the coin, Frankton last year 22-4 and lost to LaPel in overtime in the sectional 67-65. So they're back at LaPel, but this time they're playing Wabash. The Apaches come in wearing the dark uniforms. They'll be the visitors. Frankton in the home whites. Jan, we're set to go, and I think early on we're going to get a pretty good feel of what the coaches want to do offensively and defensively in this contest.
Yeah, and another piece of this puzzle, as you look out here and see the Apaches, they may have a little bit of a height advantage too, so we'll see if that is a factor as this game progresses.
Again, in white, it's Frankton. In the dark uniforms, it is Wabash, and we are underway in the regional round of the Boys State Basketball Tournament here on the IHSAA Television Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, and delighted to have you along in front of a capacity crowd, and I mean they are standing room only right now. Long-range shot from outside is in and out, no good, and the rebound comes off to Frankton. That's their big guy, Ryan Dentling. He averages 6.4 rebounds per game, and he's the top rebounder for Frankton. They don't get a lot of rebounds individually, but they spread it out pretty well.
Well, you'd love to get off to a good start on either team, but what you don't want to do is have the nerves cause turnovers.
And it's there's some nerves out there right now, Jan. I know these kids have been there and done that, but you got to feel like there's a little bit of tension going on. Backdoor cut inside and the bucket is good, and that's Caden Key, the young man I just talked about.
Yeah, beautiful backdoor cut. I've always said one of the most vulnerable places in basketball is that baseline because you don't have eyes in the back of your head.
Yeah, Key is the guy you want to keep an eye on. He's a 6'1 senior wearing number 30 in white. Wabash gets the possession for the second time of this contest. They got a good look the first time. They get a short long-range shot and a short rebound, and it comes off to Frankton again. In a hurry is Key, drops it off inside, and got a foul call for the first time of the game. It'll go against Wabash.
Well, the one thing that's happened, at least here early, is Wabash is going to shoot the three, and we've seen it. But Frankton has did an excellent job, at least early, of allowing just one shot.
Foul is on Wabash's Blake Gribben. Of course, the first foul of the game. And here is Dentling at the line now for Frankton. At the line, a 78% shooter. As a ball club, Jan, they shoot 66%. That's not really outstanding.
No, but they shoot a lot of them. You want to be up around that 70 mark.
So one out of two for Dentling. And the lead goes to 3-0 early on in this contest.
But to your point, defense, free throw shooting in these tournaments, yep, always a factor.
Especially if it's a low-scoring game like that. Yeah.
And we kind of think it might be.
Wabash with the basketball. Their first two shots have come from long range. The third one does likewise. And this time they've got it. They nail it with the basket by... Well, they've changed the starting lineup a little bit then. No, that's Daughtry. And his first 2 points. Guthrie, as we mentioned, is averaging 18.4. Now a sub for Frankton. He'll bring Hartley onto the court for the first time, a 5'10 senior, 4.7 per game, 1.3 rebounds per. That's a quick substitution for Frankton.
Yeah, it's no surprise that Daltrey is he wants to get his shots in, and you talked about he'll shoot a lot, but he only shoots 25% from three, but he'll shoot a lot of them.
So Kane with the ball out toward the midcourt line, works outside with the guard with Hartley, who just came into the ball game, was 5'10 senior. Bring it back long range. Here is Detling. Works the perimeter and a ball knocked away. Good defensive play by Daugherty. He leads the club in steals, by the way, with just over three steals per game.
Yeah, Wabash really overplaying right now, trying to put pressure extended past the three-point line.
Franklin with the basketball, penetration. There's that backdoor cut again, and a good defensive play turned in by Elijah Vanderbilden.
He timed that perfectly, didn't he, Ben?
Oh, he did, I'm telling you.
Wait a minute, they got him for a foul.
Oh, my.
Boy, that looked pretty good to me, but if one of the officials thought there was just too much body contact.
Well, they put the foul on Logan Vanderbilden. I thought Elijah was the one that made the block. Apparently, they saw something that we didn't see.
Yeah. 14 is going to the locker room. Looks like he's got a cut under his left eye.
So he'll go to the line now with Brayton Kane. He will rattle one in.
That's for Frankton, by the way.
We are told that, is it 14?
I believe. I think it's Ethan Bates.
Has been the reason they made that early substitution. Bates, one of the starters for Frankton, has been taken to the locker room with apparently a cut, Jan, under his eye.
Well, it's that physical. That's not surprising.
Well, let's hope that's not anything serious. Ball is out of bounds. It'll belong to Wabash.
Well, they got another foul called here on that backside official on number 10 for Frankenbeck.
That'll be Kane. That'll be one on him.
Yep. Well, this guy just flat out shoot it from anywhere.
Well, I guess so. Their first four or five shots have all come from either outside the arc or right inside the three-point arc. 5.5 to go in this first quarter of play. Been a hectic start, but a low-scoring game. Nice spin move inside, and a good defensive that by John Hatzel on a bad shot that time by Gribben.
Well, fast-paced start. Both teams really trying to set what they want to do here early, and you can see Wabash, as we talked about, they love to get a lot of shots up.
They're not bashful, that's for sure. Frankton with the basketball. They run a little weave out at the top of the free throw line, and here's that backdoor cut one more time, and a basket by Hatzel.
They run it to perfection. They get everybody extended, run the back door.
That's three times, Jan, they've run that same play.
And they'll continue to run it if Wabash don't stop it.
Here's the lob inside. Logan Vanderbilden had it momentarily, but as soon as he touched it inside the paint, there were white shirts coming at him from all directions. Here's another long-range three, and again a long rebound, and it comes off into the hands of Andrew Hartley.
Yeah, long threes or long rebounds, Franklin's getting most of them.
Here's the follow-away shot that's no good. The rebound taken down inside, put right back up and off the mark, and fighting forward again, and finally saved by Frankton. And now a melee and a held ball, and the possession arrow will keep it in Frankton's hands.
Well, both teams just really getting after it. But one of those 50-50 balls could make the difference in this ball game.
Caden Key comes back onto the court now. Hartley had come in to replace him, and now he is back out there. Caden with an 18-point-per-game scoring average. Open man, deep right side. Three-pointer no good, and Sky for the rebound is Vanderbilden. They'll get it back up court. Well, this pace, Dan, is really, really quick right now.
It's something else, isn't it? Hartley that time really saved the layup. Great hustle off of his defensive effort to save a bucket here. Wabash with the ball.
They are down 6-2. And that one bucket came from Trenton Daugherty early on in the contest. So for the last three or four times up, they've just had trouble getting an open shot. And here's another long-range three again, and this time they get it. That's Derek Fogel. He has 28 threes coming into the game, and that's his first of the morning session here at LaPel High School. That cuts the lead down to 6-5.
Yeah, I talked about earlier, Wabash, that was almost 500 threes for the air.
And a steal and the bucket by Trenton again. And the first lead change of the game as Wabash goes in front by one. And a 30-second timeout has been taken. The pace of this game, Jan, is quick, and partly it's because Wabash runs their offense for about two passes and then fire that baby and see what happens.
Yeah, sometimes stats don't lie, and they're not lying here. We talked about they love to get a lot of shots up, and they're doing exactly that. A little bit of the difference right now is Frankton, if they miss those shots, they're usually long rebounds. Yep. Frankton's doing a pretty good job of checking out.
Last time these two ball clubs met, you got to go back to 2004, December the 17th of that year. Frankton won it 84-55, the third consecutive time Frankton had knocked off Wabash. Wabash comes into this game ranked 39th in the state on offense, 38th in the state on defense, and 10th in the league in the state in average margin, with an average win margin of just under 19 points a game.
And now Wabash is going to put a little full court pressure. Usually you'll make defensive changes out of a timeout.
Inside the free throw line, good pass, good shot that time by Brayton Kane.
I think that was Dentley number 40.
Is it 40?
Yep.
40 instead of 10, so
yep.
Dentley gets the bucket, his first field goal, third point. And a faraway shot, looks like they're going to count it. No indication yet, but I believe they will. Basket is good.
Yep.
And the foul's going to be on Key.
Daughtry again. Man, that young man's just everywhere. He puts up a lot of shots.
Daughtry down with a half a dozen points. The average is, as we mentioned, 18.4. And returning now for Frankton is Caden Key again. He has been in and out of the lineup. And the lead is 10-8 in favor of Wabash.
Well, it's a little faster pace. I knew it could be, but I thought it might slow down. So far, it hasn't.
3 minutes and 5 seconds remain in the opening quarter of this contest.
Wabash really doubling when Frankton tries to get into the paint. Wabash really tries to double in the paint.
They're looking for that backdoor cut again. They've had 6 points come from that baseline backdoor cut. Inside 3 minutes, down to 2:50 to go now in the first quarter. Here is Key. 6'1 senior, 26 games, 18 points a game.
Oh,
gets inside
it.
And missed the gimme.
Got to use the glass there.
Intercepted up court by Hartley.
You always tell young people, I don't care where you're at, use the glass.
Now we're down to 2:25 to play in the first quarter of this contest. Doubling out high, looking for the open man. It's knocked out of bounds and stays in possession of Frankton.
You get the sense Wabash pressure is starting to play a little havoc here.
I agree.
Putting a lot of outside pressure on.
So Bates will bring it along, 5'10 junior. And again, they continue to flash Dentling out at the top of the free throw circle. That's where he's setting up the high pick and roll. Here's the shot inside that is good by John Hetzel.
Yeah, Hetzel, now with a couple buckets, really used his body and off the glass.
We are tied for the first time at 10. Clock inside 2 minutes now, the opening quarter of this game. This is about as long as Wabash has held the ball during a single possession. They have been bringing it up and letting it fly.
Everybody's team loves to be in their comfort zone.
Shot is off the mark, though, good by Daughtry. And the quick pass up court now.
Pressure again.
Away and stolen.
Pressure again.
Here's the layup. It is good. That's Daughtry now with 9 points on 4 field goals and a free throw.
He's in his zone.
And the rebound and the putback by Dentley.
Dentley,
and we're tied again.
Dentley's really been an issue for Wabash on the boards.
No basket. They'll wipe the basket off.
That's no secret why Daughtry scores the way he does. That young man's 125 miles an hour. Non-stop.
When he's standing still. Back onto the court now, or into the court for the first time, is Will Whatley, a 6'6 senior, number 44. The foul was on Ethan Bates, by the way, number one on him.
I think Daughtry might have took an elbow to the chin. He's kind of holding it a little bit. But when you go in amongst the trees, that's going to happen a few times.
Kane coming back in now for Frankton. Mark Maxwell, Kevin Moore, John Hershberger are the officials in game number one, and they're getting a workout right now.
Yes, sir. You better be in shape in this ball game.
A minute eight to go in this opening quarter.
That's why I don't officiate anymore, Beck, by the way. These games are too fast for
well,
me.
Well, you also tilted the floor. Here's the shot inside that's going to roll off the far rim, and once again, Detling comes out of there. We mentioned he's the top rebounder. Doesn't have a lot, 6.4 per game, but he's a presence inside.
Sir.
He makes things happen.
All said and done, 40 seconds left, tie ball game.
Tied at 12, big lead for Frankton was 4. Wabash led by as many as 2, and that's how tight this ball game has been. Let's see if Frankton wants to play for the final shot of the opening quarter. Instead, they turn the ball over.
Wabash coaching staff, Big says, slow it down, one shot. And I don't think they listened.
Nope. Vogel lets it fly from the far side to check that was
that's not what
volley.
He wanted.
That's a lost possession.
It
right
is
there.
A lost possession. It's one of those things, if you hit it, you're a genius. If you don't, you didn't listen.
4 seconds, 3 seconds to get it inside and got the bucket right at the buzzer from Detling. And he finishes the quarter with 7, and what a quarter it has been. That is the second lead change of the game. Nobody can escape anybody right now. After one, it is Frankton 14, Wabash 12. You're watching the IHSAA Championship Series on the IHSAA Television Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Here's Oladipo for the lead. Indiana has the lead.
To all the Pacers fans in the stands, you are who we play for.
You make us jump a little higher.
Dig a little deeper.
What a block by Turner.
It really is.
And play a little harder.
We're better because you show up to every game.
And together, we grow basketball here.
For ticket packages and more, go to Pacers.com/tickets.
You know every word of your school's fight song, but you can't remember your agent's last name? Let us know what you have and what you need. Find an agent at infarmbureau.com. Stop knocking on wood. Hectic first quarter with Franklin on top 14-12.
Wabash makes a big mistake there. They cost themselves a possession and allowed Franklin to get the lead going in the second period. Their coaches wanted a last shot. They didn't listen, missed the shot, and it cost them the lead.
So we're set to go for the second quarter. All 12 points from Wabash have come from two players, Derek Vogel with 3, Daughtry with the other 9 on 4 buckets and a free throw, and possession to Wabash to begin the second quarter of play. Knocked away, picked up by Detling. So Frankton in the white uniforms led 14-12. Starting this second quarter, they've led by 4. They have been behind by 2. They get the bucket inside.
Detling again, he's got 9. He gets down low, he's a handful, number 40.
Averages just under 14 points a game, 13.8. And they come right back with Logan Vandervelden. His first 2 points of the
yes,
game.
Sir. That's exactly right. Now, both these teams have the capability of making you pay when you make mistakes. And that's one of the calibers of a championship-type ball club is when you can do that.
Penetration inside. Bumping, a lot of body movement inside. We're going to get a foul. And it's going to be against Frankton. And I believe, yep, we're going to get number 10. That'll be Kane. That'll be 2 on him.
Yeah, that hurts Frankton just a little bit. Let's see. They're going about 8 deep right now. Let's see if they leave him in. He's key.
Well, we mentioned that Frankton has 3 players who average in double figures, led by Caden Key with 18 per. He had a 2-point first quarter. Here's the jumper at the other end by Vandervelden, Elijah Vandervelden. Well, his first couple of points.
Wabash spreading around a little bit. We thought, you know, they'd be a little one-man show, but they, honestly, they're starting to spread it around a little bit.
They're also running, Jen, a little more of an offense than they were at the outset
of the
game.
Yeah, they settled in. I think they talked about that out of the timeout. Guys, we got off to a pretty good start. Let's settle down and get good shots.
Natural shot wouldn't fall. The rebound comes off to Wabash. I mentioned they average 33.3 rebounds per game.
Oh.
Pretty good bounce that time for Elijah Vanderbilt. He has 4 points. They've all come in this quarter. And all of a sudden, Wabash back in front, 18-16 with 6:04 to go in the first half of tonight's, this afternoon, I guess I should say, our morning championship game. So we'll stay right here. Wabash led it one time by two, trailed by as many as four. Franklin scored right at the end of the first quarter to take a 14-12 lead, and now it's 18-16 in favor of Wabash.
And let's not forget one thing we may not have talked about. This is somewhat of a young Wabash ball club, only two seniors, seven juniors, and five sophomores. So it's a younger Wabash ball club.
Crowd's still trying to kind of catch his breath right now, the way the pace of this ball game is going early on. The first of two today, and then one tonight as the teams come back with the championship game.
Well, let's see what type of adjustments Frankton may have made out of that timeout. Both coaches will use their timeouts because they do not want much spread at all.
Once again, Dentling back of the lineup, working out at the high post area, now goes to the hoop and drops the ball off of the corner, and it's going to go out of bounds, and it will stay with Frankton.
Well, one thing you cannot do against good defensive ball club is dribble, dribble, dribble. It gets you in trouble every time.
Ethan Bates back onto the court now for Frankton. He'll replace Brayton Kane. These coaches are really having to shuffle some people around, Jen. They went to the bench early on in this contest.
And let's face it, a lot of times the bench is a make-or-breaker type thing because in these big games, some foul trouble can get you where you have to use their bench, and if they're not productive, it can hurt.
Well, I mentioned for Wabash, most of their scoring has come off the bench. Not most of it, but a good portion of it. Meanwhile, Frankton.
There's the back door.
There's that back door cut one more time. And Hetzel gets his sixth point of the game. Frankton averages 66-2, Wabash 66-4. Frankton gets 55.5 points of that 66-plus from their starting unit. So when they go to the bench, they don't get a lot of scoring over there.
Both teams stand, for the most part, in man-to-man. Franklin will love to switch a lot if they have to.
3 minutes gone in the second quarter. Pull-up jumper, baseline, left side. Wouldn't go. Rebound yanked out of there by Hatzell, who averages 4.5 rebounds a game.
Franklin doing a good job defensively on the boards, Bank.
They continue to move Dentling out high and work off of him out there. He got the pass inside, missed the buddy, but I believe we'll go to the line.
It was a great move by Dentling, but one thing he did not do is finish. Got a little soft there after he made his cut. Great move. Got to go up strong regardless. In this game, you got to think you're going to get fouled every time you go up to that glass.
And you probably are.
Yeah.
Elijah Vanderbilt picks up his first personal foul for Wabash. And the front end of the two shots off the mark. Wabash bringing Kalen Kelsheimer, a 6'1 junior, comes onto the court for the first time for Wabash. Dentling gets one out of two. He has 10 points.
Frankton now 3 for 6 from the free throw line. You're leaving some points there. Starting to add up a little bit.
Four lead changes in this contest already. After a 14-12 first quarter, it's 19-18 right now with Frankton in the white uniforms out in front. Derek Vogel working one-on-one defensively against Andrew Hartley. And they'll bring it back out, set the offense up one more time. Here's Daughtry. Daughtry stops and goes, got himself in trouble defensively, almost lost the basketball, picked up over there by Logan Vanderbilt.
Well, Frankton's double teaming when Wabash gets in the paint, so they got to understand that's got to be a quick shot or kick it back out.
Again, out to the point. Daughtry pulls up from the left wing and couldn't get the shot. And once again, the rebound off to Ryan Dentling.
One and done. on these shot selections for Wabash. That's why it's so important that they get the shot they want, because they're not getting very many second opportunities.
Well, they spent a lot of time working for that, Jan. It really wasn't that good a shot.
No, it really
wasn't. That effort.
Yeah, you're right. It really wasn't a great shot.
3 minutes, 22 seconds to go in the first half of this game. Here's Daughtry working his way inside. Got the bucket. I'll check it. Dentling. Dentling now with 5 points at the quarter. Has 12 already in this contest.
He's really the difference maker right now for Franklin, for sure.
He almost has his scoring average.
Yep.
With his 13.8. They'll pull up on the left wing. Couldn't get it. Rebound comes off into the hands of who else?
Absolutely. No offensive rebounds here in the second period.
You said, Jan, one and done at this end of the court. 21-18. And a foul. And they're looking at Kelsheimer. We'll wait and see. That's who it's going to be on. Kalen off the bench getting his first foul. And that is the fourth team foul, so nobody in foul trouble as of yet, team-wise.
Wabash is typically a team that averages just under 12 offensive rebounds per game. So a lot of credit goes to Franklin for checking out.
Bates will inbounds for Franklin. And thrown away.
Oh, that's a tough one. He thought somebody was cutting on the backside, and that's a lost possession. That's a tough one.
So here comes Wabash again with their 21-4 record. They have slowed the pace down considerably. Early on, it was just hectic. But right now, they're running the offense, and as we pointed out, they didn't get a particularly good shot the last time they ran the offense, so we'll see what happens this time around. Yeah, the problem inside, they cannot get the ball to Elijah Vanderbilt, who was 6'8".
Much better job patience-wise that time. Basket by number 12, that's his second.
Vander Weldon,
yep,
averaging just under 10 points a game.
But better patience that time for Wabash.
Yep.
Got a much better shot.
And the move inside, the scoop shot is good by Caden Key. They count on Key, Jan, to score 18 per game. That's only his second field goal.
Yeah, he's got four, but nice move. Both teams really attacking the paint.
Now, here's what I was going to talk about just a second ago. Vander Weldon, that particular Vander Weldon, Elijah, is 6'8". They have not gotten the ball to him consistently throughout the first half.
Yeah, and we talked about Wabash has a little bit of a height advantage.
Yeah, they do.
If they use it.
He is 6'8", being guarded by Ryan Dentling, who is 6'7". Not that there's any great discrepancy right there, but he has not had the ball very often. Here's the long shot, and the rebound comes off into the hands of Wabash again as they are down by one, 23-22, and they turn it over.
Well, both teams, every turnover feels like about three.
Yeah, it does.
You know?
So we're down to 1:05 to go now in the first half of this game, and it has been anybody's ball game as Ethan Bates gets his first 2 points of the contest. Bates averaging 5 a game, and they go back to a 3-point differential.
Wow, this place is loud the way you love it. Wabash going to be content here. They made a mistake we talked about at the end of the first period of shooting a little too quick. I don't think they'll make that same mistake here.
Well, they got to work it right down to the final second, apparently. 30 seconds to go now in the first half.
Yeah, they're only down by three, so they're comfortable. Even if they miss this 3-point deficit, it's not that big a deal, but they still would love the opportunity to get it closer here.
Now we're inside 15.
Oh, that hurt.
Oh, my goodness. A blocking foul called completely away from the ball. And they got Kelsheimer for his second.
Officials talking to the coach. Illegal pick. Illegal screen's what he's saying. He said he turned his body into him. If he stays straight, he's all right. Of course, I don't think Wabash likes the answer, but that's the one he got.
Pressure now as Kane tries to get it across the timeline. And look out.
Easy.
Getting a little physical out there. The foul is going to be called, I believe, on Daughtry.
Well, both teams are physical, guilty as charged. It's that type of ball game, but you have to be physical but under control. If you can't disrupt somebody because you're a little too physical with them, you can get their whole game disrupted. You can't, as an offensive player, you can't allow that to disrupt you.
Well, the tension's mounted, Jan, as soon as they call that offensive foul with 10 seconds to go. It's going to be on Trenton Daughtry. And Daughtry will get his first foul. Still not in a bonus situation, so no shots with 7.3 to play in the half.
Wow. This is a veteran official group. They're gonna keep control of this thing. They're gonna let them play. Nice block. Beautiful block.
And that will get us through the first 16 minutes of a hectic ball game. And at halftime, it is Frankton 25, Wabash 22. Brad Silverton doing his best to track down the coach. And Brad, let's go to you right now. Brad?
Thanks, Jerry. Coach, an exciting first half, a three-point edge for the Frankton ball team. Your thoughts?
Well, we've got to continue to rebound, and we got to get one shot done. I think we probably got to just continue to contest the way we're doing, but, you know, we've got to take care of the ball on offense and get really good possessions. We need to get deeper into our possessions and make Wabash work more.
Thank you, Coach. Good luck in the second half. Jerry?
All right, Brad, thank you very much. In the second half, if it's like the first half, will be a hectic display of basketball. At halftime, Frankton 25 and Wabash 22 in the regional round of the tournament from LaPel High School. And you're watching the IHSAA Champions Network presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
You're good at you. You've been you for years. And we're good at your insurance. You're good at laundry basketball. We're good at your insurance. You're good at stopping a gas pump on a double zero. We're good at your insurance. You're good at making funny face sandwiches. And we're good at your insurance. So start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Here's Oladipo. The Pacers want you to feel the excitement and be a part of the action. Plan your company, school, or team outing today. As a group, you can play where the pros play. Perform in front of thousands. Pump up the crowd. High five the stars. Bring the noise. Dance your heart out. Take home a part of the game. Great experiences are available for your group. Go to Pacers.com/groups.
Never miss a big game by downloading the IHSAA TV app for free on any device. For your iPhone or Apple TV, check the App Store. On your Android or Android TV device, load up the Google Play Store. Have a Roku or Amazon Fire Stick? We have the app for you. Check us out on Facebook Live, Twitter, or YouTube Live by searching for IHSAA TV. Or as always, click to IHSAATV.org for quick and easy access to your favorite IHSAA live and archived events.
Here's Oladipo for the lead. Indiana has the lead.
To all the Pacers fans in the stands, you are who we play for.
You make us jump a little higher.
Dig a little deeper.
What a block by Turner.
It really is.
And play a little harder.
Boom, baby!
We're better because you show up to every game.
And together, we grow basketball here.
For ticket packages and more, go to Pacers.com/tickets.
For the first time in forever, I feel like us. I feel like we're back to that place where we know what each other's thinking and feeling.
You know, sometimes I think we don't have enough insurance. And then I think maybe we have too much.
This is no moment for insurance. Let us help you think about it. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
It's the regional round of the boys' state basketball tournament. We're at LaPel High School on this, again, Saturday morning. One of three games we'll have for you today on the IHSAA Champions Network. You see the halftime score, Frankton up by three. They led by as many as four. They trail by as many as two. We've had three lead changes and four ties so far in this game, and it's been a hectic first half of play. here at LaBelle High School. Our guest at halftime is the IHSAA Foundation President, Matt Wolfert. And Matt, good to have you along. Are you as winded as we are trying to watch this first half?
Thanks for having me, you guys, here at halftime. I appreciate it. This first half has been spectacular, hasn't it? This is what it's all about.
I mentioned early on, if you're watching the outset of our telecast and you're thinking about coming over, don't do it, because we ain't got no place to put you right now.
This is what it's supposed to look like. High school basketball is alive and well here in Indiana, and that's what the foundation really is starting to be all about here.
Talk to me about the foundation. Now, a lot of people know the IHSAA. They know their involvement with the various individual sports, team sports, whatever the case may be. They're not sometimes familiar with the periphery of the organization. What is the IHSAA Foundation?
So the foundation was created by Bobby Cox and the executive committee about 3 years ago, really for the educational development and leadership development purposes for our student athletes, our coaches, our athletic directors, etc. The IHSAA makes the rules, enforces the rules, runs the championships. This great championship's run by the association. Creates the foundation, raise money, IHSAFoundation.org is where you can find us. Raise money so we can go out and do these educational leadership programs. Jerry, at the end of the day, we're here to protect and sustain education-based athletics. This environment today, right here.
Fantastic. You mentioned it's not just athletes. It's coaches, it's athletic directors, it's support personnel.
That's correct. One of our biggest initiatives that we've started, we're in our second year of it right now, is called the Inside Out Coaching Initiative, Inside Out Initiative. It has to do with leadership. It has to do with transformational leadership versus transactional leadership. We want to make sure our coaches and our athletic directors are focused on why they really got into it in the first place, helping these kids, making a difference in their lives. If you think about it, education-based athletics really is an extension of the classroom. Six periods of the day, seven periods of the day. The last period of the day is practice, is going out to the gym, is going out to the field, to the wrestling mat, and the coaches have to make that difference for the kids.
And I know that one of the situations that the IHSA is constantly dealing with is officiating, of trying to get just the enough officials, to be perfectly honest with you,
right.
Because it's become a situation where a lot of officials have grown in age, the veterans that we've dealt with for all these years, and we're not getting the youth coming in there. Is that part of the whole process?
Yeah, I think eventually it can be, and one of the initiatives that we can stand behind that the IHSA has rolled out this year has to do with good sportsmanship.
Absolutely.
You hear us beat that a lot, a hashtag face of sportsmanship. Well, we want to make the environment fun and inviting for everyone, but don't take it out on the officials when you do it, because you know they're not going to be here to do it, and then they're not going to be a game. We still have to have the officials, so we want to do it in a fair, good sportsmanship way.
And that's one of the issues that some of the officials said, I don't really want to put up with that anymore. So what we're trying, the sportsmanship starts on the court, and then it moves its way up into the fan base.
And it starts with the coaches being great role models for the kids. You got to remember that 97% of these kids are done with their sports career at high school level. So we need to be coaching to them, leading to them, so that they become good citizens for the future here in Indiana.
All right, Matt, if your money is always an issue,
absolutely.
How do people get involved?
Just go. We have an annual fund. You can go to IHSAFoundation.org and make a donation right online. We'd love to have you. Follow us on Twitter at IHSA Foundation. Thanks for having me.
Matt Wolfert, thank you very much, President of the IHSA Foundation. So go settle down here. We got another second half coming up here that's going to be hectic as the first half.
It's going to be awesome.
All right, so we're at halftime, and let's take a break now. Where again, the halftime score is 25-22, Frankton over Wabash. First game of three for the day on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
The Pacers want you to feel the excitement and be a part of the action. Plan your company, school, or team outing today. As a group, you can play where the pros play. Perform in front of thousands. Pump up the crowd. High-five the stars. Bring the noise. Dance your heart out. Take home a part of the game. Great experiences are available for your group. Go to Pacers.com/groups.
Never miss a big game by downloading the IHSAA TV app for free on any device. For your iPhone or Apple TV, check the App Store. On your Android or Android TV device, load up the Google Play Store. Have a Roku or Amazon Fire Stick? We have the app for you. Check us out on Facebook Live, Twitter, or YouTube Live by searching for IHSAA TV. Or as always, click to IHSAATV.org for quick and easy access to your favorite IHSAA live and archived events.
You're good at you. You've been you for years. And we're good at your insurance. You're good at laundry basketball. We're good at your insurance. You're good at stopping a gas pump on a double zero. We're good at your insurance. You're good at making funny face sandwiches. And we're good at your insurance. So start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
As we come back now to LaPelle High School, let's go to the sideline again. Here's Brad with Wabash coach Paul Wright.
Coach, it was a tough first half, but just about what you predicted, very close. How do you adjust for the second half?
You know, we got to rebound a little bit better, and we got to get in the help side. They got some easy layups on us. We usually do a pretty good job staying in the help. That's the stuff that we talked about. We got to take a little bit better shots. I thought we mishandled the end of the first quarter, but this is where we wanted to be, close game at halftime, and we got two more quarters to try and go out here and get this thing done.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck in the second half.
All right, thank you, Brad. Yeah, second half is going to be a wild one if the first half is any indicator. Here's your leading scorers for Frankton in the first half. 12 points out of Ryan Dentley from that big center spot. He had 7 of the first 5 in the second. Wabash being led by the 9 points of Trenton Dordry and only a half a dozen out of Elijah Vandervelden, 4 out of Logan Vandervelden, 3 from Derek Vogel. Jan, what are your thoughts on the second half? Well, as the coach has pointed out, we want to kind of get back into this thing.
Yeah, I thought his points was just, you know, dead on. It's from the perspective that Wabash has to rebound a little better. I thought their shot selection was a little better there in that second period. They weren't hitting like they wanted. They were trying to get, you know, a real fast pace going. Their shots didn't fall, so they got to adjust, and I think that's what he was talking to.
Well, the shot selection at the outset of the game for Wabash was really not good at all.
Yeah.
It was just bring it across the line and let it fly. When they kind of settled down, they kind of got established back into the ball game.
Yeah, Frankton wants to get the free throw line a little more. Let's see if they're able to do it here, Big.
Second half is just now underway. The winner coming back tonight, by the way, for the championship game and the right to move on to a semi-state game next Saturday. Here's the driving layup to the baseline. Back outside, long-range three, one of the first long-range shots we've seen from Ryan Dentling.
Well, Wabash just talked about checking out and rebounding and a much better job that time by Daughtry, I should say, on checking out.
Class 2A is what we're dealing with. Covington and Alexandria will battle in the second game of the day. Three fouls now on Brayton Kane after getting two there in the first half. Second half just getting underway in the dark uniforms. That is Wabash. Here's a foul prior to the basket coming in from behind. Now let's see if they put this on. They're looking at Bates.
I think they got Bates, yeah.
That's who it is. Ethan Bates getting his second foul. Nobody in foul trouble. And, Jen, with the hectic pace of the first half, we still never got into a foul situation bonus-wise.
Well, and I think what may happen here was because everything started to get just a little physical at the end of the first half, you might see the referee kind of tighten up here just a little bit.
That's a good point. We were just talking, Matt and I were just talking about part of the foundation is getting new coaches and fans and officials and the officials here, as you pointed out, John, this is a veteran crew. They've been around for a while, and they're not going to let anything get away from them.
Beautiful block.
Oh, my goodness. And the Wabash coach thought there was a foul committed there, but to no avail. Here's Daughtry in the left corner. They drop it inside and cannot hang on to it. That's Logan Vandervelden.
Ethan Bates timed that block beautifully and got the block.
Here it is again.
Yeah, take a look. And blocking shots, something I kind of love, is absolutely a timing perspective.
Here's the steal in for the layup, and it is good. That's Daughtry. He's double-figured now with 11. Trenton averages 18.4, so he's also the leader in the ball club with assists with 4 per game and steals at 3.2 and second in block shots with 15 coming into this contest.
Well, Wabash kind of got a freebie there. They're going to put some full-court pressure when they can. And now you can kind of see what's developing. Everything's paint-driven right now.
Foul will be on Wabash. And the indicator is number 12. That's Logan Vandervelden. That'll be number 2 on him. nobody in any serious foul trouble.
And I think that both these veteran coaches understand, and they've talked their teams at halftime. They're not opposed to the outside shot, but get it in the offense. Don't just come down and just throw up a three with nobody under rebounding or no extra passes.
Key fouled in the act of shooting, misses the front end of the two shots. He's a 64% free throw shooter, and he missed them both. So it's 25-24, and the layup is off the mark, no good by Logan Vandervelden. It'll go out of bounds and stay in the possession of Wabash.
Well, a key stat right now is Franken's 3-for-8 from the free throw line, and they're starting to come back and haunt them a little bit.
Four lead changes, four ties so far in the game. Wabash is led by as many as two, and Franklin has been in front by as many as four, and those were both early on in the contest. Since then, it's just been exchanging buckets. Here's the basket by Daughtry.
Well, and he stopped on a dime. Much better shot selection by Wabash. Boy, he got elevation on. That's just a great offensive possession and a good shot.
And the sixth lead change of the game, and now the shot is missed, and the rebound comes off to Wabash. They average 33-plus rebounds per game. Frankton, 27 rebounds per game. One-point ball game, 26-25 in favor of Wabash with the basketball. Dark uniforms working the goal to our left. Third quarter of play, and lost away and picked up by Frankton. They will fire from long range, and it's no good. And the rebound taken down inside by Elijah Vandervelden. He averages 6.4 rebounds a game, which tops the Wabash Apaches' defensive rebounding total.
That wasn't a bad shot by Franken, but I think they could have got a better shot.
They got in a hurry. Here's Wabash inside. Oh, what a good-looking shot by Blake Gribben. That is the first basket for Gribben. A little left-handed shot that you could do nothing about, and the lead goes to three, and the biggest lead of the game is chopped down to one in a hurry as Dentley comes back and gets the bucket, and at the other end,
number 12, Logan
Vandervelden.
Wabash running the court really well.
Boy, it's just up and down basketball as it has been literally from the outset. Long three, no good. Rebound on the deck and out of bounds. It belongs to Wabash.
Well, Franken's got to understand they're not shooting very well. They've got to get a better shot. When you're not shooting the ball real well from outside, you got to slow down and see if you can find a better shot.
Wabash is averaging 74.7 points per game in the tournament. They put 86 on North Miami, 75 on Oak Hill, and 63 on Manchester.
Boy, it's furious in there.
It is furious. They are allowing only 46.3. In fact, they beat North Miami 86-35.
Franken needs a bucket here. They've kind of been dry for a while.
They have 2 points on one field goal coming from Ryan Dentley here in the third quarter. Franken averaging 56 points in the tournament. Their top game was 61 points. And the driving layup is good by Bogle, giving him five and giving Wabash a five-point lead. That's the biggest lead of the game for the Apaches. It is a full timeout, so we'll take a break on the IHSAA Champions Network presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
For the first time in forever, I feel like us. I feel like we're back to that place where we know what each other's thinking and feeling.
Sometimes I think we don't have enough insurance. And then I think maybe we have too much.
This is no moment for insurance. Let us help you think about it. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Hey fans, don't just hope you're covered in the event of an emergency. Find agents in every Indiana county at infarmbureau.com. Stop knocking on wood. Along with Big Chad Bosier, I'm Jerry Baker. The rest of our crew on hand on this Saturday morning at LaBelle High School. And the first game of the day, which will lead up to the regional championship later on tonight. All of a sudden, Big Chad, it's Wabash.
Well, and you hope you can make a run at some point in time. And Wabash found one. Now, the question is, can Franken find their run?
Wabash is being led by Daughtry. He had 22 points against North Miami, on hit 7 out of 8 free throws, 26 against Oak Hill, hit all 6 of his free throws, and against Manchester, he had 30 points and hit 17 of 21. So, Jan, if they go to the line with Daughtry, he's pretty much money in the bank. Long three.
Well, I don't. Franken's living and dying by this three right now.
Hartley came off with the rebound, makes the move inside of the traveling violation against Franken.
Well, Franken's still just playing. I mean, they're only down 5. It seems like more than that, but it's not. But they have not been shooting well from outside. Now, you got to think they got to go inside a little more.
Well, Brent Bobston, who is the head coach, who's the ball out of bounds, has got to be a little concerned right now. This gap cannot get a whole lot wider.
Oh, good point, Becky. In a game like this, we talked about 5 seems like 10. 10 seems like 20.
Battles on number 20, Hetzel. Number 1 on him. John, one of the problems that they're having, Franklin, is they can't get the ball to Caden Key. He averages 18 a game. He has 4 points right now.
Well, they're being doubled in the paint. Paint's awful crowded right now. But the way you make that go away is get ball reversal. Get the defense to move a little bit.
Blake Griffin to the line. 39% free throw shooter. That's his third point of the game. Did not score in the first half.
It's only his second free throw for Wabash. They're 2 for 2.
Rebound off to Ryan Detling. He's having himself a pretty good ball game. Detling, 14 points. His average is 13-8, so he's there already. And a foul from the outside official. And I believe they'll get Elijah Vanderbilt in for that.
Well, and I think this is a good call. Nobody likes that call where the hands are straight up. But clearly his hands were leaning forward, and that'll get you. I completely agree with coaches. When the hands are straight up, that's good defense.
So Key is at the line for the third time. That's his first make so far. Caden had a field goal in the first and a field goal in the second. Since then, he's really not handled the ball well that much. Half a dozen now for Caden, 6'1 senior.
Franklin now 5 for 10 from the free throw line, Big.
Now I mentioned they're not a great free throw shooting team at 66%. 33-29 ball game. Here's the long three. No good.
That could have been huge.
Knocked out of bounds, and last touch by Franklin.
Not a bad shot by Franklin because he was wide open. They had a couple of passes, and it just didn't fall.
4-point lead for Wabash with the basketball in the dark uniforms. This is Daughtry. Almost threw it away.
Wabash has scored 11 in this period. That's the most they've scored here so far. They had 10 and 9. 10 in the second, 9 in the first period.
Inside, shot no good. Foul's going to be called. It'll be on Detling.
Franken's got to do a better job of getting some backside help, because if you get beat off the dribble, somebody's got to help you, or it's going to be a bucket, a foul, or both.
Blake Griffin, a 6-foot senior at the line, has 2 points, so taking 3 points. And now 1 for 3 from the free throw line.
Wabash now 2 for 4 for the ball game. Both teams really struggling.
So 4 points for Logan Vanderbilt. His average is 9.7. And we're to 2 minute, 2:20 to go here in the third quarter of this game. Ball goes out of bounds and a held ball. Possession arrow gives the ball to Wabash.
Great sportsmanship that time. You can play hard in these games. And when it's time to stop, you stop. Great job by both teams.
Wabash has won 9 straight games by an average of, Jan, this is remarkable, 25.7 points a game. So the last 9 games of the season, they have just dominated their opponent.
That's when you want to get hot and play your best ball.
Rebound again to Detling. Quickly up court, layup is good.
Got it, boy. That was a tough one. Beautiful shot.
Kane getting his first field goal of the game. And a double dribble called against Wabash. They'll turn the ball over.
Wabash called a timeout here, Bake. Bacon's got the crowd in it. They got some points. This is a good timeout if you're a Wabash fan.
34-31 is your score. We'll stay right here and kind of update you on what has transpired. Frankton led at the end of the first quarter of this regional game, 14-12. At halftime, they were up by three, 25-22. Jan, they only have two field goals here in the quarter, and they trail 34-31.
Boy, this has been a shot selection nightmare, really, for both teams. Both teams are just working hard to generate offense. Frankton's really struggled from outside. Now, they've made some better decisions here in the last couple possessions. But, boy, how hard is it to get a good shot right now? These defenses are really kicking in.
It's a lot more physical than I anticipated, I'll be honest with you.
Well, we'll see if Frankton can continue their little run here. Wabash had theirs early, Bake.
Frankton inbounds beneath their own basket. Get the ball inside to Detling, their big 6'7 senior. He's been a key. He has scored 14 points, but he's been a presence all over the court. Inside, bucket is good. That's Caden Key.
Yeah, a couple back-to-back buckets by Frankton.
That's what Key is, only his third field goal of the game. He has 8 points, averaging 18 per. Ball is thrown away and goes right back to Frankton.
Here may be the run Frankton needed. Wabash now a little rattled.
We're talking about Key. He has 12 games with 20-plus points, a high of 34, and those 34 points came in the game against LaPel on this same court. So he's comfortable here. Caden passed 1,000 points last year, number two on the school scoring list. And what's interesting, Jim, for Caden Key, he's the third 1,000-point member in his family following his sisters, Kelsey and Katie.
This could be big for Frankton. Still trailing by one. They've made a little run and back to one, Bake.
Long range. Hartley's on the court now for Frankton. He was the first sub off the bench.
Oh!
Basket is good. I think they're going to count it. It'll be by Caden Key. Basket is good. And the foul is on Blake Gribben.
Key has been a big factor of this comeback for Frankton. He's brought a lot of energy and got him back in this thing.
He has 6 of their 10 of the quarter, and Caden goes to the line. 2 out of 4 from the line, 64% free throw shooter.
Makes it 2-point lead.
36-34, half a dozen lead changes in this game. Inside a minute in quarter number 3.
Boy, how big would a bucket be here by Wabash? Frankton stole the momentum, and a late second shot by Wabash could pull it right away.
So a 5-point lead has dwindled down to a 2-point deficit right now with the clock down to 32 seconds to go in the quarter.
Wabash made a mistake early on, if you'll remember.
Did not wait
and allow Frankton to get an extra shot. I don't think they're going to make that same mistake. You're okay if you're 2 down, but you got a great opportunity here to put some points.
And they turn it over again with 7 seconds to go. That's the way they ended the first half. Here's the loose ball picked up. And good!
You got to be kidding me.
Strange shot by Caden Key.
You got to be kidding me.
That's the end of the third quarter, and Key, we mentioned he was struggling, 4 points. He has 9 in the quarter and 13 in the game, and it's 38-34 as we go to the fourth quarter on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
Never miss a big game by downloading the IHSAA TV app for free on any device. For your iPhone or Apple TV, check the App Store. On your Android or Android TV device, load up the Google Play Store. Have a Roku or Amazon Fire Stick? We have the app for you. Check us out on Facebook Live, Twitter, or YouTube Live by searching for IHSAA TV. Or as always, click to IHSAATV.org for quick and easy access to your favorite IHSAA live and archived events.
Man, I'm 3 points short here. I don't know where.
Okay. on which team.
We are back now live with the 38-34 ball game in favor of Frankton as we start the fourth quarter of this ball game. And right now, Jim, in the third quarter, Wabash had all the momentum going in their direction, and suddenly they find themselves down by four, which is their biggest deficit so far in the game.
Well, Wabash made their run, got it up a five-point lead, and all of a sudden, Frankton just hung in there, and they got really back into this thing with their defense, turned it into some offense, and all of a sudden, a young man by Caton Key. Boy, sometimes it's your day, and right now it's his day, at least in the third period.
Little delay here, and I'm not sure what this is all about.
Yep, had a little discussion, not sure either, but they got it sorted out.
We've got them all straightened away now. Little delay as the fourth quarter gets ready to go. Frankton will get the ball to begin the fourth quarter of this contest. So here we go, Jen. Eight more minutes to decide who's going to advance to the state tournament.
And how big could this be if you're Franken, got all the momentum, got the ball? Boy, if you could get one here, that'd be huge.
Well, we talked about Wabash was at the point where they could break the game open. Now we're talking the other side
of the
coin.
Exactly right. You kind of felt like both teams would make a run. Great pass.
Oh, what a beautiful assist. The pass came inside from Caden Key to Ryan Dentling. Dentling gets the bucket and draws the foul on Blake Griffin, his third, and now he'll go to the line. Dentling has really impressed me, Jen. This young man, a 6'7 senior, has three games with 20-plus points, gets the free throw with a high of 31 against Westfield. He also passed the 1,000-point mark back on February the 8th against Mississinewa. He is number 8 on the school scoring list.
Now, if you're Wabash, you can't come empty-handed too many times. And here's your guy, three-pointer by Daltrey.
Trenton now with 16 points in the contest. His first three-pointer, he leads the team in three-pointers, or second on the team with 41. Jasper Walters has 42. He has not been in the game. Here's the layup inside that won't go. Boy, Jen, it's a dogfight when that shot goes in.
Much better job of checking out by Wabash.
36-41, long three, no good. Foul's going to be called outside. It'll be a three-point shot foul.
That's a no-no. You want to pressure shooters. But the last thing you ever want to do is give a good shooter three opportunities to make three here.
And, Jen, that's the fourth foul on Kane.
Yeah, that's big. That may be worse than the free throws.
So the five-point lead, which we had a second to go, is the biggest of the game so far for Frankton.
Yeah, the four fouls is really a lot of time to be played.
Rattles this with us also. And again, we mentioned he hits three shots. Daughtry, a 75% shooter from the line on the season.
Got him all.
Now with 19 points of the game. His average, 18-4. So the five-point lead is cut down to two in a heartbeat.
Wabash did a pretty good job of hitting their free throws. 6 for 8 right now, Beck.
Again, Frankton in the white uniforms. Wabash in the dark unis. And inside, the ball is out of bounds. It'll stay in possession of Frankton. Frankton 23-3. Wabash 21-4.
Well, Frankton's doubling down deep in the paint. And Frankton's got to recognize that when they get the ball down low, they got to kick it back out. Somebody's got to be open because Wabash has really elected to protect the paint here in the final minutes here of this ball game.
The Associated Press had Frankton preseason ranked number 4, and that's where they finished up the year. Sagarin, which ranks all the schools in one fell swoop, has them ranked number 78 in the state. Wabash is ranked number 100, according to Sagarin. And that's all based on some statistical analysis that are pretty complicated. Points per game, defense, power of your opponents, things of that nature. But it gives you some idea where they fit in. Frankton had its first unbeaten home court record since 1988. They had three road losses this year by a total of 18 points. Long three. Got it. Oh, wow. Andrew Hartley.
How about your first bucket of the ball game? A 20-footer. That's big.
His 32nd three-pointer of the year. They come back at the other end and try one. It won't go. And the rebound comes off to Franken. Their lead now again back up to five at 44-39 with 6:14 to go in the ball game and a turnover at the timeline.
Untimely. Franken's did a pretty good job of not turning it over. That one hurts. When you got a five-point lead, you don't want to do anything to allow your opponent to get any type of momentum going here. Let's see if Wabashkin can take this turnover and put it in points.
6:10 to go. The shot won't fall. It would have counted had it gone. And it's going to be a foul called against. So it's on Dettling. That'll be two on him. And we will send Daughtry to the line.
He's a perfect 4-for-4 on the ball game.
He's made a living at the line.
Yes, sir. Got that one as well. I'll tell you, that he may be the smallest guy on the court, but he's also the quickest.
He's listed at 6 foot, but that might be pushing it just a little bit.
Yeah, he elevates, and boy, does he got a first step.
That cuts the lead down to a three again, 44-41, as Guthrie knocks them both home.
Well, Wabash 8-for-10, and if they somehow figure a way to win it, the free throws are certainly a piece of that.
Trenton, by the way, with 21 points in this morning's game. 5:50 to play. Frankton. Wabash should set this defense up, and it got broken down by Brayton Kane.
Boy, Kane now with four, and that none bigger than that one. He had a beautiful first step.
5 points now for Brayton. His average is just over 8 points a game and leads the team in assists with four and steals with two. Inside all by his lonesome. There's the big guy, Elijah Vanderbilt.
Vanderbilt with eight.
That's half a point higher than his scoring average of 7.5. 30-second timeout taken by Brighton. 5 minutes and 20 seconds to play in this contest. This is one of two games here today, Jan. Covington and Alexandra waiting in the wings, and if it's anything like this, then the people really got their money's worth.
And I think it will be. I think it's going to be a physical, hard-fought defensive ball game. We're now with 5:20 left in this one, a 3.1 possession game. Now it's turning into a possession ball game. Can't turn it over, got to hit your free throws because every possession now as that clock ticks down becomes so important.
This is a game where, Jan, one or two mistakes can really dictate the outcome.
Yeah, and right now just a small little factor is Wabash is 8-for-10, Frankton 6-for-11 unofficially. But still, those have now come into play because it's a three-point ball game.
So here comes Wabash showing a full court pressure. And Frankton has no trouble breaking it, get it across the timeline, set up the offense. This is Brayton Kane at long range. Here's Hartley. Hartley's done a good job, Jan. He was not at the starting lineup, but came into the first couple of minutes of the game.
Yeah, all you'd love is for on a certain game, a person off the bench step up and make an impact. Tough shot.
And the putback is up and good by Dettling.
Boy, Dettling, 19 now, Bank. He's been solid all game.
He had a 12-point total at halftime. Has come up strong here again in the second half. And a long-range three by Daughtry. My goodness.
There's nothing better than when a young man has so much confidence that he's willing to just take that shot and drill it. I love it.
He just cut that 5-point lead down to two in a hurry.
Yes, he did.
Second three-pointer in the quarter. 43 for him on the year. He's having a terrific game. He has all but 2 points that Wabash has scored here in the fourth quarter.
Boy, it's a shame one of these two ball clubs have to lose. This has been one well of a ball game, Bank.
24 points for Daughtry, 11 scoring here in this quarter. 4 minutes exactly to play. We're halfway through the fourth quarter.
But you'd much rather play with the lead because the clock's your friend.
Out of bounds, and they're going to stay in the possession of Franklin. I thought for a moment they were going to get the blocking foul call along the baseline, but not the case. 3:52 to play.
Well, there was a lot of possibilities there that could have been blocking. You thought maybe he steps out of bounds, and for whatever reason, we're on a, you know, a little ways away. He got the ball back.
They're blocking, charging out of bounds. Been, pick one.
Yeah, it could have been anything.
Mopping up some perspiration. And, again, this is a packed house. In fact, there are people standing in the entry areas with no place to go and waiting for a seat after some of these fans exit, perhaps, after this game. Well, we're back in action again.
Every possession so huge.
Two-point lead for the team of the ball, Frankton. Well, it's been fun to watch this game.
Oh, it's been a great high school basketball game.
Hartley comes back out to the long range again. This time, again, they bring Ryan Detling way out high, Jan. He's trying to draw the big guy out. Now he goes inside and gets the layup, and the basket's going to count. And they're looking at Vanderbilt, and we'll see.
Well, that's just pretty basketball.
It is.
Well, you got the lead. The clock's your friend. Move the ball around. Continue to work it towards the goal. That's exactly what Franken does, and they get it to their money, man. He lays it in. He's got seven in this period, 21 on the day.
Foul was on Griffin, number four on him. And he goes to the line to Stetling and can't get the roll. Jan mentioned 7 points in the quarter, 21, or make it 21 of the ball game. And the lead goes back to four again. Little teardrop out front, they got it.
Daltrey again. 13 in this period, 26 on the night.
Well, he has scored again, all but 2 points in this quarter for Wabash. Here's the ball knocked out of bounds. And a foul prior to the ball going out of bounds.
Well, you better check this guy out. I think they got a foul, and Detling's going to go to the free throw line. You got to check him out. You have to assume that he's attacking the goal at all times.
Foul was on Logan Vandervelden. That'll be his third. And here is Ryan. Eight points in the quarter, 22 of the game. High of 31 this year, if you're wondering.
Got to hit free throws. Frankton now 8 for 14. Got that one. 9 for 15 now for the free throw line. Frankton.
Substitution now for Frankton. In the back onto the court is the starting guard, 5'10 junior, Ethan Bates. Bates averages 5 points a game. Second of the ball club and assists with 3.3 and steals with 1.9. He has 2 points total. Jumper will go.
All about the effort.
Taken off by the shooter that time, Blake Gribben. Long three, no good. Rebound to Frankton.
Well, they got a couple good looks. Didn't fall.
Offensive foul called against Frankton. It'll be on Key. That'll be two on him.
Well, here's the deal. That's one of those could go either way calls. If you're Frankton, you don't need to take that risk.
No.
You have the lead. Reverse the ball. I'm not agreeing or disagreeing with the call, but as a player, no sense taking that risk.
2:40 to go. 52-48. Frankton with a 4-point lead. Neither ball club has been able to establish any kind of dominance in this game. Frankton's led by as many as five. They have trailed by as many as five. Clock winding down to 2:20. Long three could cut it out.
Oh,
they got it.
Oh, my.
Long range three by Derek Vogel.
Oh,
his second three of the game. His 30th on the year and 8 points for the 5'11 junior. And a timeout taken by Wabash.
Full timeout.
And it is a full timeout, so we will take a break. You're watching the IHSAA Boys State Basketball Tournament on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
You're good at you. You've been you for years. And we're good at your insurance. You're good at laundry basketball. We're good at your insurance. You're good at stopping a gas pump on a 00. We're good at your insurance. You're good at making funny face sandwiches. And we're good at your insurance. So start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Hey fans, this Monday night at 7, the IHSAA Champions Network will air the 2019 Boys Basketball Semi-State Preview Show live on IHSAATV.org. Join Greg Rakestraw, Chris May, as they break down all the boys basketball semi-state matchups 2019 Boys Basketball Semi-State Preview Show. That's at 7 o'clock Monday night, only on IHSAATV.org.
This kind of reminds you of the old adage of the prize fighter. Both teams just laying great punches, and neither one will refuse to go down.
It has been fun. The only people not having fun right now are the coaches. But they're trying to figure out how they can either overcome a one-point deficit or hang on to a one-point lead. Inside 2 minutes, fourth quarter. Backdoor cut was blocked away, picked up though by Frankton. They look for the outside shot, penetrate inside to get the layup from Caden Key.
That's just great basketball, I'm telling you. This young man's been the difference maker in the second period. Just great decision making.
He had a 9-point third quarter. He has 15 points of the game. Here's the pull-up shot from long range. It won't go, and the rebound comes off into the hands of Caden Key.
Now, if you're Frankton, you got to be smart. Take care of the basketball. Only take a great shot.
And if you're Wabash, you've got to put the pressure on but not commit the foul, perhaps. There may reach a point now. Frankton's going to take a timeout, a full timeout. With 1:15 to play, we will take a break likewise. It's 54-51 Frankton on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
The Pacers want you to feel the excitement and be a part of the action. Plan your company, school, or team outing today. As a group, you can play where the pros play. Perform in front of thousands. Pump up the crowd. High five the stars. Bring the noise. Dance your heart out. Take home a part of the game. Great experiences are available for your group. Go to Pacers.com/groups.
Back down at LaPel High School, Terry Baker, Jan Bosier, the rest of our crew. Jan, we're watching other regionals around the state. You've got something out of Logansport?
Yes, sir. Carmel down at halftime by 8, comes back and wins 58-42. So the number one Greyhounds will advance.
They were playing Fort Wayne Northrop, a 16-8 ball club. So Carmel will advance to play the winner of Huntington North and Zionsville later tonight. And as we get scores rolling in, Big Jam with his magic fingers will pass it along. Right now, we're a little occupied with one heck of a basketball game. A three-point lead. Final 1:14 to go. Frankton has that three-point advantage, and they have the basketball.
Well, Frankton, as we talked about, got to be smart here. They're going to endure a lot of pressure by Wabash.
Ethan Bates handling the basketball out high. Now they work the right side and set up the offense again. And this is Caden Key, the guy they want to have the ball in the hands of. And here is the foul. Foul's going to be called on Logan Vanderbilt, number 4 on him.
Got to be careful there. Just making a foul, not an intentional. The official's going to give you a benefit of the doubt. But Wabash, I think, makes the right decision. You just got to have some clock to play around with here.
And I'm watching Wabash. Jasper Walters will come into the lineup, I think, for the first time for Wabash. Elijah Vanderbilt and back out there, Jan. That's the 7th foul against Wabash. So the 1-1 is now in effect. And the first one is good. Bates, first time to the line. 70% shooter on the season. That's his 3rd point of the day. He averages 5. And gets 1 of 2. 4-point ball game, 55-51. Inside a minute, 45 seconds to play.
Still 2 possession game.
I think a traveling violation,
That one hurts. That one hurts.
Trying to lean in, Jan, and pick up the foul and got caught on the traveling violation.
Still all kinds of time. If I'm Wabash, I go for a quick steal if I can. If not, I got a foul. I've just never been a believer in letting the clock go too far down.
Well, you're down by 2 possessions, as you pointed out. If it's 1 possession, maybe you can milk it a little bit longer, but not right now.
Yep.
Frankton gets the ball inbounds, and they quickly commit the foul. Got a couple of players to choose from. Foul will be on Jared Holly. Just came into the lineup. Here comes Jasper Walters, who came in, then went out, comes back into the lineup. One of the reasons Walters is in there, he's a good three-point shooter, had 42 on the year. So now Detling goes to the line. And again, it's the one and one. That's the eighth team foul. And Ryan has hit 3 out of 4 in the quarter.
Oh my, missed another one.
Rebound off to Logan Vandervelden.
Break it down, 10 for 18.
Long three is an air ball. Now we're inside 30 seconds, and again the foul. It'll be on Walters. That'll be the first on him. And the clock shows 27-4. Just a little heads up. We'll have a little break between this game and our second game. Then we're back with that contest for you. Then we're back tonight at 8 o'clock on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance, with the coverage. Free throw is off the mark again, this time by Bates. And a timeout taken by Wabash.
Full timeout, Wabash.
And it is a full timeout. 24.3 seconds remain. 55-51 your score. Franklin leads Wabash on the IHSAA Champions Network, presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
For the first time in forever, I feel like us. I feel like we're back to that place where we know what each other's thinking and feeling.
You know, sometimes I think we don't have enough insurance. And then I think maybe we have too much.
This is no moment for insurance. Let us help you think about it. Start with Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance and stop knocking on wood.
Well, it's been a hectic game that we've enjoyed, and I say the word enjoy because it's been fun to do this particular game, and it's not over yet, Dan, with 24.3 to play.
This gym holds 3,051 people. Now that 51st person hasn't breathed since the tip-off because he's been squashed. There literally must be about 3,200 in here.
I tell you what, they are standing room only here.
Here we go.
They got to have a basket, and they got to have it in a hurry. Don't need the three, but they got to have something. Here is the three, and it's good. That is Vogel again.
Three three-pointers for Vogel.
He has 11 points and a quick timeout again.
Well, Wabash not going away. That's pretty evident. This young ball club really scratching and clawing.
All right, now that's the last timeout that Wabash has. So here's your scenario. You're 14.3 seconds away from somebody moving on to the night game. It's a 55-54 game, Frankton. And the ball would be in Frankton's hands, Jan. If you're Wabash, how much time can you wait before you commit that foul? You can't just let them run their offense.
Almost none. I think you go for the absolute steal right out of bounds. And if you don't get it, you got a foul right away.
Well, even if they go to the line and make it, you're still a one-possession ball club.
Yeah, that's very true. It'll be interesting. And it'll be double bonus after the next foul. So
I'm just watching the coaching staff of Franklin, Brent Robson's guys. They are worn out.
Yes, sir.
I've watched them down here. We're pretty much right behind them, and I've been watching the Wabash guys to our left down here. And, of course, the head coach of Wabash, Paul Wright, has been working diligently.
Wabash needs a steal. They don't get that. They pass it inbounds.
Oh, my. Oh, my. Oh, almost a steal. And it is knocked away. And out of bounds, stays in the possession of Franklin. Oh, what a dangerous pass that
was. Well, you can thank Hatzel because he literally went after a 50-50 ball. And honestly, that may have been the difference in the ball game.
Well, they have called a foul on Holly. That'll be two on him. And now the double bonus. And Hatzel goes to the line. For the first time tonight, 63% shooter.
None bigger than that one.
Oh, boy.
Franken now 11 for 20 from the free throw line.
7 points now for John. Averages 10 and a half per game. Yeah. So it's still a one-possession game, and Wabash is out of timeout, so they've got to go for three. And Derek Fogle's been their big guy from three-point land. He's on the far wing. They'll take a three, and an air ball, and it gets into the hands of Frankton, but apparently out of bounds.
Wabash will have one opportunity to tie this thing up.
You know, they had Bogle absolutely wide open on the far side of the court, and they didn't see him, and he's the guy that's got the three-point range. All right, we're showing 0.6 seconds left on the clock.
They may put some more on here. Let's see. Now, 0.6, you can dribble and shoot.
Other officials coming over to the table now to talk with the...
Vic, I'll tell you what, these officials did an outstanding job. This is a tough, tough ball game to officiate. They've allowed a good flow. They've called fouls when they need to. They got a little physical. They got it all calmed down. People, unless you've officiated, have no understanding how difficult, but they made it look easy.
Jen, here's what I think is happening. I think the official is merely saying to the timekeeper, are you comfortable?
Yeah, they're going to talk about it.
With what's on the clock. Because they can't use replay. That's not allowed. So they have got to go to the officials and say, okay, they've got to put 0.1 seconds on there.
And when you're one possession down, every point something can make a difference.
Well, they want to get the ball in the hands of Derek Bogle. I know it, you know it, and they know it. So number 5 is the key for Wabash. He breaks to the left wing. They go to the other side. Here's the three. Oh, it cut the rim. What a game. Just a sensational high school basketball game. They don't get much better than this.
I'm exhausted.
Oh, my goodness.
Unbelievable basketball game. I'm telling you, you could not have asked for a better high school basketball game. One of the best I've seen in some time.
Brad Silbert is standing by, and in a moment, we'll try to get a comment from the winning coach, Brent Brobston, assuming he has a moment to talk with us. Let's go down to Brad right now. Brad?
Came down to the last 0.7 seconds, and your players prevailed and got yourself a three-point win.
Yeah, you know, we've just battled back in every game, and when we got down in this game, we thought we had to speed the game back up because it was becoming obvious that Wabash was starting to take over the game. We needed to change the tempo. We did the same thing in the sectional, so the kids were familiar with it. Give Wabash credit. They're a great team, well-coached, and we just had to battle, and we did it.
Jerry Baker said there's over 3,000 people in the gym who are just having a ball, but there's coaches out there who are probably all worn out. How are you feeling after the game?
Yeah, I mean, it takes your energy. But the kids obviously deserve the credit to battle back and be aggressive and do what we did. It's all for, you know, the team deserves all the credit for this.
Congratulations. We'll see you tonight at 8. Thanks, Coach.
All right, thanks very much, Brad. Brent goes to 182-92 in his 11th year at Frankton. And none, I would imagine, Dan, came much more difficult than that. And Wabash finishes the year 21-5. Paul Wright goes to 62-77 on the year. Jan, let me get the stats here just briefly, scoring-wise, and then we'll kind of wrap things up. For Frankton, 57-54 winners. By the way, neither club got more than a five-point lead in this entire game. Both ball clubs had a five-point lead at one time. Their leading scorer in the game with 23 was Ryan Detling. He had a 9-point fourth quarter. He was really the key to the game. The points that he scored, Jan, by the way, are significant, but I thought his presence in the game was just key.
Yeah, he felt comfortable of taking charge when he needed to. And those players, I call them special, because you need those players that when you need something, that those types of players know when and how to step up, and he sure did.
And the other player in double figures for Frankton was Caden Key. He is their leading scorer with 18, and he finishes the game with...
We had fans come here.
15 points now for Caden Key in the game tonight. And Wabash was led by Trenton Daugherty, Daugherty with 26 and 11 now for Derek Vogel. So we will take a break. Frankton will play the winner of game number two that's coming up shortly between Covington and Alexandria. We'll take a little break and get back in about 15 minutes of that game for you on the IHSAA Champions Network presented by Indiana Farm Bureau Insurance.
For the first time in forever, I feel like us. I feel like we're back to that place where we know what each other's thinking and feeling.
You know, sometimes I think we don't have enough insurance. And then I think maybe we have too much.